learned members of bar.
I am a justice for last 8 plus years, 9 years running. So for the first time, I am here to say something before the members of the bar. So, as Madam Naimada said, that a judge becomes a congestion. Judge loses his or her capacity or quality to become a good speaker. So I'm not a good speaker. There are some good speakers in the bench, like Justice Iman Ali, Justice Tariqul Hakim, Madam Naima Adan, Sir Jifa Naume. They are good speakers. Anyway, I've been asked to deliver lectures on the issues which are brought to the notice of the court. And there are some apparent loopholes in our act. So, as Masood said, that I have pronounced a judgment, actually not one judgment, I have pronounced a number of judgments, but this judgment has been reported in one of the law journals, the Apex Law Report, Southern Solar Power. So, the fact of that case was that whether a foreign party or any of the party of a foreign arbitration is competent to approach the court. Here court means the high court division. I will come back to this point. There is another point that the court means the high court division and the district court as well, as the definition given by the Indian law. So I'll come to that point later on. So the question before this court was whether a party to a foreign arbitration is competent to approach high court division. There were a number of decisions from our jurisdiction that the scope of application of Arbitration Act of our country is very limited. Only the arbitration which has been taking place in Bangladesh, the parties of that arbitration are allowed to approach high court division. But in my judgment, I had to examine all decisions, the judgment delivered by my predecessors, and the laws which are in place and which were in place before the enactment of 2001, and also the law of other jurisdictions. And finally, because my decision, the ratio which has been laid down is that the parties to a foreign arbitration are well competent to approach high court division. And in fact, today, the senior counsel, Mr. Arthur Hussain QC, was delighted to go through the judgment that he wanted this sort of ratio. And although lately, at a belated stage, I came to know that he had actually written an article on this issue. There were some questions, and when I went through the article written by Adolus and QC, and I found out that I have answered all his questions in my judgment. So, this is the one issue which I was requested by Masood to address. That what is the scope, what is the extent of application of our law? That is Section 3 of Arbitration Act 2001, in tandem with Section 7 and 7 A, capital A. So Section 3 of our Arbitration Act, the marginal note of Section 3 says that scope of arbitration is scope of application of Arbitration Act 2001. It does not deal with the jurisdiction of our court. There is not a single word in Section 3 which limits the jurisdiction of our court. It simply makes a sort of general statement that the provisions of Arbitration Act will be applicable if the seat of arbitration is in Bangladesh. But it does not say that the court cannot interfere in dealing with Section 7A's application or dealing with Section 10's application. In proviso, it says that to make it clear that if there is a foreign arbitral award, then there are provisions in this act and it will be applicable. But there is no prohibitory provision for the court. So, my opinion that since 2000 Act has provided the jurisdiction in Section 7, which starts with the Hausner clause, that notwithstanding anything contained anything in any other law, the court shall not interfere in an arbitration matter. So that is the first provision. And there is some permissive space. So permissive spaces are that if the parties to the arbitration approaches the court with regard to appointment, with regard to interim order, and there are some other measures like for referring the dispute to arbitration tribunal or for determining the jurisdiction of arbitral tribunal under Section 20 or for enforcement of an interim order passed by the arbitral tribunal, etc. There are some other functions of the court. So, Section 3 does not limit the power of the court. So that is the decision I have given. And not only by examining the relevant laws, but also upon dwelling on all the relevant judgments given by my decisions. Particularly the decision about which the Learned Senior Counsel, Mr. Adnan and QC has concerned. That decision, this TX decision and other decisions. So I have discussed all the decisions. I have discussed the fact of the case and the reasoning behind arriving at such a conclusion. The next issues which have been requested by myself to discuss is Section 42, Subsection 2. And also the execution. So a foreign arbitral award currently is being executed by the district judge. So in the opinion of most of the learned lawyers, it is not an appropriate forum. The appropriate forum should be high appeals. Although they say that it is the appropriate forum, but I don't find anything wrong in making that forum to the existing court. But the High Court Division, if the legislature finds it appropriate, in that case the High Court Division may be the executing forum, because currently I'm the presiding judge of the Arbitral Division. So I'm executing number of cases. So since this court has the power and experience of executing the decree, which is very cumbersome, so if a decree of a civil suit can be executed, of course an arbitration award can be executed by the High Court Division. But it is for the legislature, and it would have been better for the organizers to invite Honorable Law Minister here so that he could have taken a first-hand knowledge from this symposium that instead of making the district as the executive forum for an international arbitral award, the High Court Division maybe made the forum for execution of international arbitration award. And there are some other issues, in fact, a number of issues, but due to shortage of time, I'm not going to touch all these issues. I have somebody has noticed it. I'm going to touch upon an issue which has recently been dealt with by me. Recently, one party was Turkish supplier, the other party was Bangladeshi statutory body, I think it was the Milk Pita. So Milk Pita wanted to buy some equipment from Turkish party. There was an arbitration clause, but it was sort of a peculiar arbitration clause. Only when the Bangladeshi party will choose for rules, international rules, there are ICSID rules, there are other rules. So there are four rules. Only when the international party will be notified by the Bangladeshi party that Bangladeshi party has chosen a rule, only then the arbitration will start. So when there was a dispute, the milk bidder purposefully was not selecting a rule. So this foreign party was encountering this, was facing this problem. For a few months, they were trying to convince the Bangladeshi that it is your duty to select a rule. Until and unless you select the rule, I cannot go for arbitration. But in that arbitration agreement, the parties did not select the place of arbitration. So it was open. So if the place of arbitration is not selected by the foreign parties, then they shall be at liberty to select Bangladesh as the place of arbitration. So the foreign party issued a notice of arbitration and accordingly approached the court for formation of arbitral tribunal. Anyway, it's a long story. And lastly, my decision was that the Arbitration Act of 2001 is applicable in this rare circumstance. And I don't know what happened. I have delivered the judgment only a couple of months ago. So I've been asked to leave this, now. And I wish that I will hear some more updated lectures from our learned senior counsel, Mr. Panelist, and of course from Mr. Anil Chagora. Thank you all.